Today, we're revisiting the tutorial for background removal using Photoshop Mix. And that's coming right up. G'day, this is Doug from Doug Hewson YouTube, and we're here to help you with tech wherever possible. Today, we're going to revisit the tutorial we did some time ago using Photoshop Mix to remove your background from your photos. Hey, if you're into technology, software, Mac, PC, iOS and more, why don't you consider subscribing to this channel and get videos like this one and a whole lot more. Don't forget to check the bell so you don't miss anything as it's posted. Hey, let's get right into the video. Now, last time that I did the tutorial, when I put it up and I showed a very basic way of cutting out. Now, there's some added features in Photoshop Mix that I didn't go into, and today we're going to look at those a little bit more detail. Again, in the premise of cutting the background out for the purpose of making something like just cutting out your head, your face, cutting out an object for YouTubers that would be useful for making thumbnails. So we're gonna look at how we're gonna do that. So let's go back to trusty Photoshop Mix. And you can see I've been playing with that since. I've got a couple of my old cutouts there from my iOS recording tutorial. So we're going to add a picture today. We're going to take a picture with my iPad, and then we're going to bring it in. We can actually take a picture from within Photoshop Mix. A couple of things. You can see I'm wearing a blue shirt. So one of the things that you want to look for when you're taking your photos in the first place is making sure you've got something contrasting in the background, so that make it easier, something plain. Don't take it outside with a lot of foliage. I learned that one the hard way. What you'll find, that you'll get all different depths and colors, and it'll be very hard for it to find the definition of the outline that you're looking for. We've got some light, we've got a cream color background, which is gonna be a bit uneven, but we'll use it anyway. I wanna make a thumbnail, I wanna cut myself out. It's a little bit awkward, not the best background. I need to look at the lens. I keep looking at the screen. This is really awkward. I don't know how vloggers do it. Okay, so I'm gonna pull a... That'll do. And we're in the Photoshop Mix. Let's see if we can do this. Now, we're casting a bit of shadow. I was a bit close to the curtain, not the ideal, but now we've got the photo in the Photoshop Mix, which is the first step. So what we're gonna do is go to the cutout like we did before. Now, last time we had used the smart cutout. There's different options there. I can go auto, and it's gonna do something here. Let's see what that does. It's basically giving me a rough idea. You can see it's a little bit rough around the edges. And there's a bit of overlap. So that's giving me the auto. You could go with that. I could X out of that and say no. I like to go start with the smart and then work from there. So you can see over the cell, we've got add and subtract. We've got add selected. Everything's transparented out. So I want to select myself. So I'm going to start running my finger sort of around, covering different sections. As it reads the section, it knows, oh, that's a very different color there. So let's get up around the head here. And it's a little bit rough there. Get that as rough and ready to see. There's a few bits around the neck there that are not cut out quite right, and around the head. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to go to the subtract again, see if we can fill in some of those bits. Now you can zoom in by pinching out, grab those really rough. I'm dragging with two fingers to do this. That's actually quite good around the neck there, and up here in my eye. That's scary. And we can sort of go in there. You can see how it's really rough along the edges. So I'm gonna pinch that back out. We're gonna go to another tool now, which is called the lasso. Now I'm gonna leave it on add because I wanna go around the edges here, draw a basic line there. Anything that I highlight is probably gonna be added back in. We can like do some smooth lines. You can see that now if I go subtract, I can sort of run my finger there. You can get like a smoother. If you had an iPad Pro with, say, a stylus, you might be able to get a little bit more fine control. We can smooth out some of these rough edges. Obviously, I've got a bit of a here and there, so we're subtracting still, so I can just sort of... I'm just trying to go for smoothing out some of the bumps just by using the lasso tool. Just to smooth out the edges somewhat. As we zoom out, you can see the edges on this side here. And as you can see, you can just use that lasso tool to fine tune. You can do basic shapes and stuff using the shape tool here. If you wanted to add or subtract with a shape, the refine tool and the smooth tool smooths all the, it just gives you like a feather, like you could in like Photoshop, whatever, you can feather the edges, which is may not always be practical what you want there. But yeah, there's different tools there which you can go with. And then you've got your basic brush control where you can just sort of brush and add it featherly. I like to use the lasso and the smart tool just to get most of it done and just touch it up. So that's mostly what we want now, so that we're done there. Anyway, you can see what it also does is it trims the picture up again. So now the checkered area is like a PNG, is transparent. So there's our cutout there. Now it's still a little bit rough. You could do a bit more work on that. Again, similar to the last tutorial, it's the same sort of thing. We've just gone through a few more of the cutout features. Go back out to the main menu and let that save. As it does a little save, it saves it to your little Photoshop Mix account, Adobe account, whatever you like. And also, once that's done, we can export that to our camera roll like we normally do. So if we have a look at our camera roll now.
Well, I hope that tutorial was helpful for you today. If you really liked it, give it a thumbs up. And if you want more videos like that, don't forget to subscribe, like I said before. There's going to be a subscribe button down the bottom here for your click in just a moment. And if you want more videos like this, I've got a couple of examples on either side here for you to watch. Until next time, this is Doug Hewson YouTube, and I'll catch you later.